Making art is like falling in love blindfolded. When you paint or write, you hug the air, trying to give form to what stands between you and the world. You want to be heard. You imagine an audience. Every work of art is a message in a bottle thrown into the sea. You hope someday someone will pick it up. Most of the time, the artist is a sailor on a sinking ship. He has to spread his message around before his ship goes down. The ritual of boarding a plane. A beautiful blonde middle-aged flight attendant whose legs I admire every time she passes by. The video showing how to use your floating device, your oxygen mask. Subtle noises from the hidden belly of the steel whale. Testing the wings, air circulation, seatbelts being clicked on, dimming of the overhead lights. A large flat TV screen showing mind-numbing purple images. Wallflowers. Flowers. Lakes. How many of us on this plane right now are thinking about death? What I want to do with my work, a reverse archaeology. Bury myself under many layers so I can unearth myself again and again. I am both the archaeological site and the archaeologist. Write a poem with black permanent marker on a light green apple or yellow apple. A love poem. Let the apple decay. Let the poem decompose. At a gas station, an elderly woman with a brand new silver Mercedes. She's trying to pump gas and asks me for help. Is this the first time she's been out on her own? It seems that she doesn't even know how to make a call on a public phone. Is she well off or maybe ill? It's much easier to imagine her as a wealthy rather than a victim of a medical condition. One of the disadvantages of being rich. Sometimes you are cut off from the most elementary routines. And on love, a New York lawyer, Bert Puga, hired three thugs to blind his ex-girlfriend. This was 1959. The lawyer spent 14 years in jail, and when he got out, he asked his ex-girlfriend to marry him. This journal is just a way of paying attention